Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about writing algebraic expressions, our second video on this topic. Now, I want you to think about something we already know about numbers. Suppose I gave you the number 2, and I said triple it and then add 4. So you have the number 2, and you would triple it, so you'd multiply it by 3, and you'd get yourself 6. Then you'd add 4, so we're going to add 4, and you get yourself the answer 10. Now suppose I said add 4 and then triple it, so do the same operations but in the other order. Would you get the same answer, do you think? Let's give it a go. You take 2, we're going to add 4 to it, and you get yourself 6, and then you're going to triple it, so you're going to multiply that by 3, and you're going to get 18. And you get a different answer. And it's pretty obvious. Because we know the way addition and multiplication works, we know that the order, if you're doing a multiply first and then an add, it's going to be different to do the same add and the same multiply after. So it's really important, the order matters there in which you do it, and you get different answers. Similarly, if we have similar instructions with our algebraic expressions, we say take x and we multiply it by 3 and add 4, that's going to be different to taking x, adding 4 and multiplying by 3. So we've just got to be careful at what's happening first. So we're just going to do examples like we've done in the first algebraic expressions 1 video, but just drawing out how things that might look the same are in fact different. So example, start with x, we're going to double it and subtract 3. So here's our x, we're going to double it, so multiply it by 2 and we get 2x, and then we're going to subtract 3 and we're going to get 2x subtract 3. So that's our expression for those steps, 2x subtract 3. However, if we started with x and we subtract the 3 first, so we subtract the 3 first, what do we get? We're going to get x subtract 3, and then we double that answer. So we're going to double this. Now, the way I'm going to write double this, I'm going to actually put a bracket around that to protect it, to show it's like the first step. So I'm going to keep that there, x subtract 3, and I'm going to double it. And I'm going to put 2 there just to say I'm doubling the x subtract 3. Don't worry about whether I can, what's called expand brackets, etc. We'll come to that. But I'm just going to say it's 2 lots of, 2 in front of x subtract 3. Put a bracket around it to show it's 2 times the x subtract 3, the whole thing, not just 2 times x. Because if you just wrote this, you might think it looks like the one above, doesn't it? But these two are very different from each other. In this case here, we are doubling the 2 and then taking away 3. In this case here, we are taking away the 3 and we are doubling the whole thing by 2. So that's why we need the brackets there. So it's really important that you see the difference between those two. They are very different from each other. Right, let's have a go at some more. Start with x, divide it by 3, then add 5. So we're going to start with x here, we're going to divide it by 3, which would be x over 3, and then we are going to add 5, so it's going to be x over 3, add 5. That's our answer, x over 3, add 5. This case, we're starting with the x, we're adding the 5 first, and then dividing that answer by 3. So it's going to be different, let's see how it looks with algebra. Start with x, we're going to add that 5, we're going to have x add 5, and we're dividing the whole thing by 3. So remember I said, just put a little bracket there to remind you you're dividing all of that by 3. So we get x add 5, and all of that divided by 3. And you can have your brackets there, or you don't have to have your brackets there, it doesn't matter. And so up here the expression would have been x add 5, all of that over 3. And hopefully you can see it's very different. X over 3 add 5 is different from x add 5 all over 3. So it's really important you understand the different steps that occur in these scenarios, and it's going to be really useful later when we're solving equations so we know the steps to undo the process. Right, let's try another. Start with x here, add 4, divide by 6, then subtract 2. Start with x, going to add 4, what does that look like? X add 4, put a bracket round it to show we keep that together. We're going to divide that whole thing by 6, so I'm going to have x add 4 with nice brackets round it, divided by 6, and then we're going to subtract 2, so I have my x add 4 over 6, and that whole thing, I'm going to take 2 off at the end, and it's as simple as that. So that's our answer here. X add 4 over 6 divided by 2. Some more examples. If you're feeling confident now, you may want to pause the video and try these yourself and then check with me. You start with X. You multiply it by M. And multiply it by M. How does a mathematician write that? They write MX. They could write XM as well, but we usually put it in alphabetical order, so MX. And then you subtract C. And I subtract C from this. MX subtract C, like that. Okay, and there you go. The only difference here, the slight more difficulty, is that we weren't multiplying by numbers and subtracting numbers, we were multiplying by algebraic terms and subtracting some more algebraic terms. Maybe you want to have a go at this. You start with R, you square it, so that means you multiply it by itself, you multiply it by R, you get R squared. And then you multiply by pi, which actually is a really important number we'll learn about in geometry, but you can think of it as just another algebraic term here, and we would get, well, you could get r squared pi, or pi r squared, and this is the one mathematicians go for. They put the ones with no squares, the lower powers first, and they put the higher powers after. So we would write pi r squared. And last one, write an expression that results from the following steps. You start with R, you cube it, so you're going to multiply it by itself. There's once, there's twice, there's three times, you're going to get R cubed. And then you're going to multiply that answer by 4/3 pi. Now you could write R cubed 4/3 pi, but I bet you think that's pretty messy. We would write these things, the number first. We would write the pi next because it's got no powers, and the r cubed last. That's going to be 4/3 pi r cubed. And that's it for this video, writing some more complicated algebraic expressions. Thanks for watching.